Welcome to my channel and thank you for taking the time to watch this video. I would also like to welcome Spirit into this reading and say thank you for the messages we are about to receive. This is a general reading. So you've got the Spear card over here. So you've got heartache over what you no longer have. So there could have been some loss. There could have been some separation that you went through, where a relationship ended. And you're still going through the healing process of that. You've got this... I really don't know what it is. It's like a spear thing piercing the heart over there. And, you know, there's a lot of bloody tears over here. So something really, really upset you. Something really, really broke your heart. You've got the rainbow card over here. And it says that the most difficult part of the situation is over. So you have gone through the worst here and you are now starting to get over with it. So, you know, the drama is now finished. You are dealing with that heartbreak card over here. You've got the chair filled, and this is so good because you've got someone new entering your life. So you went through something very difficult. You are starting to overcome it, and it looks like somebody brand new is going to be entering your life soon. So a new relationship coming in for you. Now, in the past, you've got the justice scales over here, so keep your life in balance. You could have also been dealing with a legal breakup or a legal circumstance, a divorce, and that's what you've been going through. And this is probably why you're very, very heartbroken. Now, you've got a meeting with a stranger, which could be important. So there's somebody that you had an encounter with who gave you some information, or maybe it could have even been this person that you're getting together with. But there was somebody that you met who was a stranger, and that was a very important meeting that you had. Because it seems to have changed your direction in life. Now, going to the future, you've got the Ram card over here. And I always say this is about maybe you're dealing with an Aries person, a stubborn, aggressive person. So you're having to sort things out with this particular person. Or you could just generally be dealing with somebody who's just really stubborn and giving you a little bit of grief. The fact that this Ram is facing to the past means that it's somebody that you dealt with in the past and you're having problems with this person. You're butting heads with them. And then you've got the broken ring, parting of ways in either romance and business. So, you know, it could be, this previous relationship that you had, you are now ending it completely. You're parting ways with them and you are no longer going to be in their influence. You know, the contract between you and this person was broken. You can see that broken ring over there. So, you know, it looks like it was a legal ending to that circumstance. And now you are now parting ways with them. This could also be about you changing jobs. So you could be breaking a business contract. You could be even going off on a new direction as far as your work goes. So, you know, you could be starting some kind of brand new job and signing new contracts, but leaving the old behind. So those are the energies for that, that week, really. So I'm going to just use the Mona Lisa Tarot for the main read. You've got the Knight of Wands over here. So this is about things moving very, very quickly. But this is also about relocating and doing your job somewhere else. So travel. So maybe the job that you're going to be doing is got a lot of travel in it. There's a lot of learning as well involved in it. You've got this man carrying a scroll there. But also, this is about dealing with people who are foreign to you, going to foreign countries and working with foreign people. So this is a new opportunity coming in for you pretty quickly. And it's going to involve a lot of travel, or it's going to be involve a lot of people, foreign people that you're working with, or, you know, you relocating to do that particular job that you're doing. So you've got the seven of cups here, seven of chalices, and the Judgment card crossing it. So you are making changes. You've let go of the past, and you are going back to doing something that you originally wanted to do. This is the Resurrection card. Maybe, you know, whatever that circumstance was, you felt like all is was lost, but it doesn't seem that way. It seems like you're changing direction. The Judgment card is, you know, being called upon to make a decision to change the way you're doing things. And it's also reaching that crossroads in your life and doing something that is now going to be very successful, because you've learned a lot of hard lessons from going through a lot of difficult circumstances. And you've overcome it, because this man is rising from the grave. So something that completely destroyed you seems to have, you know, you are emerging victorious. This is, you know, almost like a phoenix rising from the ashes of whatever happened, resurrecting something that was old. Somebody could even be coming in from the past to give you a little bit of a hand, a little bit of guidance as well. You can see these people holding clothes for this man. Excuse me. It looks like, you know, they're there to help him. They're there to clothe him. They're there to give him food. So a lot of help coming in from you, for you, now that you've changing direction in your life. So whatever happened with you was really deceitful. You can see this woman's poisoning the wine for this man here, and she's hidden behind a veil. So a lot of things, a lot of nastiness went on behind the scenes. This is on the emotional front here. You know, maybe you didn't know you had people that were so against you, or that people were causing a lot of drama, a lot of problems for you. You know, like you can see, this man's being poisoned, and you didn't know that they were against you, or they were doing things behind the scenes and causing a lot of, you know, they may have wanted to see your downfall, really, with that Seven of Cups. It's such a deceitful card, and, you know, this woman is hidden behind the veil, so things going on behind your back that you didn't know, were unaware of. This man is sleeping, and he doesn't even know that people are trying to kill him. So they may have been trying to work you out of that situation itself. So it's a card of a lot of lies and deceit and underhanded behavior that went on. But you are overcoming that. You're taking a new pathway, and you are emerging as somebody who is victorious in that particular circumstance. And this is probably why you're going to be leaving that particular situation and moving on. Now you've got the High Priestess over here, and this is about being divinely guided in what you want to do, but also having done a lot of studying, a lot of learning. Maybe you've ended up, you know, being a lot by yourself. You've been following your own instincts. You've been getting a lot of inspiration or insight, but it looks like you may have been doing a lot of study as well with that particular card. You've got the Ten of Wands, so end of difficulties, difficult situations, burdensome situations. You've crossed the river. This could be the River Styx, so crossed over onto the other side now, leaving behind that which is, you know, was difficult. He's turning around to look at, or, you know, how far he's come, but he's now going to be taking his rod and moving forward. So you've got your new idea, your new plans, your new projects. You're going to be moving forward. You are reviewing the past a little bit, but you are now making plans for the future, really. So what's in your mind? You have are still very, very anxious with this Nine of Swords. You might be feeling very pressurized in this particular circumstance. Maybe a lot of people making a lot of demands. The Nine of Swords is also about being unable to sleep, a lot of anxiety, a lot of stress coming in as well. So that's what you are going through at the moment. Now, things are going to, you know, things are looking up over here. So you could be signing some new business contracts over there, signing something legal. The Ace of Swords is about cutting out that past and being victorious in whatever you're doing. Now, whatever job you're going to be doing is going to be very intricate, very, very, you know, very refined. This is a seamstress working with, you know, needle and thread. So very, very, you know, logical, very specific, maybe even scientific as well. And, you know, producing these beautiful garments over here. So, you know, you're going to be building up something as well. And you're going to be very focused and very, you know, working on it. So this could be a new contract that you're signing for a new job. If you're dealing with legal circumstances, it's also about victory in a legal situation. But it looks like this new work is going to need all your skill set. And you look, it looks like, you know, you're well learned for this, because you've got that High Priestess card. You've been studying for this, and whatever you're starting now, you know, it's the end of a burdensome situation, the end of the difficulties, and now you're going to be moving forward. It's also maybe, you know, it's some kind of job where you have to speak clearly or express yourself pretty clearly, but it's something that's going to require your expertise, and it's something that's unique to you. Whatever expert you are, it's something that is a very unique thing, and you're going to be working pretty hard at that. Even with the Sun card, it's about working extremely hard, being very, very focused, working long hours, but working for success. So you are going to be working pretty hard, and whatever you're going to be doing, very, very focused. You can see even both these people are very focused. This man's got a chisel and hammer in his hand, and this woman's got this scissors in her hand. You're cutting out the past, you know, making plans, being very precise, and this man is also very precise work that you're doing. So you, and you know, the Sun card is about working long hours, but lots of success coming in with that Sun card. And then you've got the Four of Wands, so working with a group of people. So you might be involved in, you know, in charge of this group of people, or, you know, heading a project maybe. This could be also about travel, and this is about, you know, setting down roots as well, and also getting success. This is about meeting a lot of people, a lot of travel as well involved in that particular job. Well, these people are wearing masks, so just, you know, be careful of the people that you work with. This is a really good dynamic project that you're going to be doing, or something really dynamic. But, you know, sometimes they're not revealing who they are. So, you know, be aware of that. You know, sometimes people have hidden agendas. They could well have hidden agendas. So, you know, just keep your information or your sensitive information to yourself. But it looks like, you know, it's going to be something good. You're going to be able to work well together. It's a good project. It's going to be successful. Just keep secrets to yourself, really. Now, you've got the Emperor card over here in your hopes and fears. You're afraid that, maybe you're afraid of leadership. Maybe you feel that, you know, you don't have enough authority, or you don't have enough training to do this particular job. You're very worried. This Emperor looks extremely worried. He feels unsupported, and he feels a bit stuck. You know, it's almost like he doesn't know what to do here. So that's what you're afraid of. You're afraid of maybe taking control and authority, but you have the expertise to do whatever it is you are doing, and you will be successful at it. So don't let your insecurities, you know, dictate the outcome of that situation. Now, you've got the Eight of Wands, so some news coming in is going to set the world on fire, really. So some, you know, the Eight of Wands is about things moving very quickly and big news coming in, and you know, it's going to be something that changes the course of events. You could also be doing a lot of travel with this Eight of Wands, but definitely news coming in there. And you've got the Six of Cups over here, so somebody giving you a helping hand. There's an offer coming in for you, so there's this big offer coming in. You've got a lot of waters, so there's a lot of emotional fulfillment coming in over here. And finally, this Nine of Cups, which is satisfaction and emotional fulfillment. You can have eating all the apples, having all the apples you need. So it's going to bring in a lot of abundance. So whatever this new offer is, whatever this job offer is, whatever this helping hand is going to bring in a lot of satisfaction and a lot of abundance. And it's going to make you feel really good about yourself as well. You know, you'll be able to relax and enjoy all the fruits of your labor there with that Nine of Cups. It's a wish being fulfilled. So I'm going to just draw some cards from the Animal Tarot. So you've got the Eight of Summer over here, which is the Eight of Cups. And you feel that there's more to life than that what you're living. So it's time to move on. You may be moving from a situation that isn't good for you, or perhaps you're being drawn to what would make you happy. Either way, you are in control. So whatever is going on over here, you are moving. You can even see that with that Knight of Wands, moving away from whatever that circumstance is into something better. So, you know, you are walking away from an old situation. Maybe it caused you a lot of anxiety, and moving away to something more prosperous. And then you've got, and you can see even that with Judgment card, transforming yourself and moving in a new direction. You've got the Star card over here, so you are about to take a big leap forward in your life. Worry will be replaced by optimism, fear with hope, and joy is coming home to roost. So with the Star card over there, it's being guided, but it's also getting all that hope and wishes being fulfilled. And it's a big change. It's the Star card. You've gone through a lot of drama. You know, you've gone through the Tower moments, and you've gone through the Devil moments where you've been manipulated. Tower card being, you know, having lost everything. And now the Star card comes in. It's that hope, and you know that it's going to be successful. You've got a lot of stars in the card over here. So, you know, some kind of international thing that you're going to be doing. Definitely opening up, you know, to a broader audience there with that star card. And there's news coming in, and there's great transformation coming in over here. This bird's bringing in the news, so you are going to be getting some positive news coming in. And then you've got the Queen of Summer over here, so it's a time for deep emotions, heightened intuition that you can completely trust. Be mindful you don't ignore your own needs while caring for others. So beginning a new phase, taking control of the situation, you know, being that swan, somebody who's in charge and over, you know, in control of things, and make sure that you're looking out for your own happiness rather than anybody else's. It seems like for too long, you know, you've been worried about what everybody else says, but it's time for you to take care of yourself and move forward. So it looks like some big changes are coming in from you, for you. You are moving away from an old circumstance. You are starting, you know, this old circumstance was really nasty, but you are moving away with that Eight of Summer, walking away from a difficult situation. You know, it was very cloudy, very confused situation. The Star card is guiding you, and it looks like, you know, you're coming into your own, beginning a new cycle with that new moon over there. And you're going to be working pretty hard, but you're going to be using all your skills and your talents, and your very unique talents as well. And it looks like, you know, it ends with the Wish card, which is this Nine of Cups, which is saying that you're going to be very, very satisfied at what you're doing very soon. So I hope that this reading has resonated with you. Please don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and leave me some comments if it hasn't. Thank you so much for watching. Take care now. Goodbye.